I'm back from my exams. Tough days out all round, but I reckon we got round. So anyway, it's time to talk about the tour, time to talk about what's going on in the world of cycling since I've been gone. Video's coming up, we've got Juan Ayuso, we're going to do a lot of stuff about him in the under 23 Giro, and we're also going to be talking about the big boy Damian Caruso and his power numbers and how he managed to get on the podium. Then we're going to do some tour previews and just some random races like Adriatica Ionica is on today. But anyway, this is Route de l'Occitanie, stage 2. It was an interesting race, maybe. I think it could have been better if it had better coverage, and the riders there were a bit rubbish because it got rearranged. Well, other races got rearranged. There was like Belgium Tour, Slovenia, and Suisse all on at the same time, and obviously this one. So in terms of the sprint quality, it's not the best. But I want to talk about Arnaud Demare today, mainly just because I really like him as a bloke. Just seems top bloke all round. And also, I think he's got a very good chance of copping a stage. Now, obviously, he's already won stages in the past in the Tour, most notably the one where Sagan body checked Cav. And here we have Ineos leading out for Ben Swift. It's not really going to work, basically. They know it's not going to work, but they just want to keep him towards the front. I think this is Amador on the front now. And it's sort of like Ineos' C team. They've got like Duel there and some other Randys, but Brandon Rivera, Bernal's mate, was also there. He's actually not too bad. Can't have too much abuse to him. But anyway, FDJ, you're like, where are they? They're just hiding now. They're just on Ben Swift's wheel. They know, like, there's no point getting to the front now. There's, like, 2K to go here. And it's quite a small race. So, like, you know, there's not many sprint teams to contend with. You just wait back and sit back. And then whack it at the end in the last couple kilometers. Now, we are going to lose some footage at a key point. But I think we can ignore that and we can still see the point I made. Obviously, today he didn't really beat anyone. Well, not today, but like last week, he didn't actually beat anyone that good. Lorenzo Manzan is like good, but not, you know, outrageous. Anyway, so FDJ have now decided it's time to move up out of Ineos. And this bloke on front now, his turn is huge because he gets FDJ from being in decent position to just being on the front. And it's a technical finale. Very, very technical. Lefts, rights, roundabouts, everything you can imagine. And it's not, okay, it's not a wide road, but it's also not narrow. And when you're at the front, just look how much more pedaling you can do around the corner. Like, as in, they just pedal around all the corners. You know, it's like, not too much brake on the entrance to the corners, not too much sprinting on the outside of it. And also, like, look at this, where they pull off around the corner so people can't pass them on the inside. This is top stuff. This is the sort of stuff that they teach you in Belgium when you're 2, or in France when you're 4. But, you know, it's just good stuff. And this is now the last climb. So they managed to basically make sure no one's dive bombing. We've got a left and another right here. And just look at Arnaud Demare. He sort of leaves a gap here because he knows he's going to have to sprint out. Now we lose footage here, but it doesn't really matter. What we're going to be able to see is that FDJ go on the front and absolutely launch it. Now this finale was like decently steep. I'd say it got up to 67% at the end of the finish. And Demare, I think, is quite good at these uphill sprints. Like, just, okay, obviously he's not going to win, you know, up Mur de Huy, but on these ones he can do quite well. So FDJ, now Guarnieri is on the front, absolutely launching it. Manzan's got to close this gap. Demare was quite clever and let Manzan go really, really early. So Manzan's in the wind for a long time. And it looks like, to be fair, Manzan's got it, but then Demare comes around at the end and just, cheerio, thanks for coming. I think there should have been a time gap given there almost. He was just different level. Manzan almost crashes. Just so binned, but it was a long effort as well. From the bottom of that corner to the top of the hill was probably about 40 seconds or so. So a pretty long sprint. I think Demare letting the wheel go and going behind Man and letting Manzan open up, very good tactics. Obviously the level here isn't outrageous. I assume Manzan's going to the Tour, but the key point is that he's got an outrageous lead out train. He wins consistently all year in like random French races, like the one last week, I can't even remember what it's called. He won like every stage. It was outrageous or something. Like, I think he didn't want one. But I just think he's top bloke, good lead out train. He's French. Just everything's going for him. So I reckon he's going to be a big hit out. A big chance of him winning a stage. Viviani won today as well, but again, didn't really beat anyone big. We beat Marachko. Is he big? That's up to you. For me, no. And then the other man we're going to talk about is Cav. Obviously, is he going to go to the Tour? Maybe, maybe not. I don't really know, but he's good at that contract negotiations, trying to get some more coin from Lefebvre. And apart from that, Ewan looked so. Bennett's probably the number one favourite. Ewan, I was surprised Cab battered him so badly in the final one, but he did win some other sprints in the Belgian Tour last week. So that's it from today. Videos are going to be banging out left, right, and centre. I'm also getting a new bike, actually, my Els Vanyar. It's gonna be light. I've got my carbon saddle came today, got some other stuff on the way. It's gonna be an outrageous build. So we're gonna have a fair few videos on that as well. Have a bit of training videos as well, and all the rest of it. So we'll see you in the next one.